Alleluia. And welcome to our Eucharistic celebration. Together then, let us offer a Hail Mary to the patroness of our parish, Mary, Star of the Sea, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Mahalo. Let us turn and greet one another as we prepare for this celebration. A little reminder, please turn off your cell phones before we begin our gathering song so as not to disturb the celebration of the sacred liturgy. Mahalo. We will have a second collection today for our schools. Thank you for your continued generous support. Today we celebrate the 19th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Our presider for this Eucharist is our pastor, Father Frankie, assisted by Deacon Rafi Mendoza. Please stand and join us in singing our entrance hymn, This is the Day, which will be projected on the screen. This is the Day.
Celebrate this Mass today, let us dispose ourselves to listen for the small voice of calm which invites us to come to Jesus over the stormy waters of life. We begin our Eucharist in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Coming together as God's beloved children in Christ, as we thank the Lord that He is going to nourish us and feed us once again with His very life to strengthen us, to confront the challenges of today's world, especially this pandemic. Let us call to mind our sins. We ask the Lord's pardon and loving mercy.
I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
We adore you.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, whom taught by the Holy Spirit, we dare to call our Father, bring, we pray, to perfection in our hearts the spirit of adoption as your sons and daughters, that we may merit to enter into the inheritance which you have promised. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
are redeemed from the hope, are redeemed from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, I speak the truth in Christ, I do not lie. My conscience joins with the Holy Spirit in bearing me witness that I have great sorrow and constant anguish in my heart. For I could wish that I myself were accursed and cut off from Christ for the sake of my own people, my kindred according to the flesh. They are Israelites. Theirs the adoption, the glory, the covenants, the giving of the law, the worship and the promises. Theirs the patriarchs, and from them, according to the flesh, is the Christ, who is over all, God blessed forever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Jesus Christ.
An elderly woman, widowed for so many years, was taking a leisurely walk around the park. Then all of a sudden, a teenager came, accosted her with a bladed weapon, and demanded for money. Slowly, the elderly woman opened her purse, and then the teenager saw inside the purse not just loose currencies, loose bills, but there was a diamond ring. And so the teenager demanded, "Give me the diamond ring." Disheartened, the elderly woman gave the ring. The teenager left, and the elderly woman slowly was looking for any possible witness, or probably would walk, looking for the next available police officer that she could see. Meanwhile, as she was walking, again the teenager appeared to her, returned the ring, and said, "I am giving this back to you because I am thinking, what is it in you that made you give me this ring? Give me what you have that is within you, where you freely give up this ring. What is it within us? What is it that we have that allows us to continue on the journey of life amidst the tears and the laughter, the deaths and the lives, the challenges, especially today, that we face? Have you ever considered that? When your friends, family members, co-workers would see you and utter these words, 'Give to me what you have within you that I may discover the meaning of life,' what would be your response?" Our readings gives us this perspective. What is it in them that allowed them to continue on to be witnesses for God? In our first reading, we generally are familiar with Elijah in this particular instance, where Elijah was in a cave and speaking to God. There was the earthquake, the thunder, and the storms, and the fire, and God was not there. And we are familiar with this, Elijah discovering God present in the still small voice. But maybe it's important for us to realize the bigger picture, why Elijah needed that experience, why God allowed Elijah to encounter him. You see, it came in that history that Israel was divided between the northern kingdom and the south. And in the north, at that time, the king was Ahab, the wife Jezebel, and they decided to forsake, to give up the laws of Yahweh, and instead, they institutionalized a commitment to follow Baal or Baal. So that was the situation in the lives of these particular people. The leaders gave up on God and decided to pursue a different God, a foreign God. It is in this calling that Elijah confronted all the priests of Baal, because Elijah saying, "If I could prove to you that God, Yahweh, is greater, follow him. If not, then follow Baal or Baal." And this confrontation with all the 450 priests turned out to be such that God, Yahweh, was proven to be stronger, and therefore all of these priests, 450 of them, were killed by the people. When Ahab and Jezebel heard about this, they gave Elijah a warning: "By this time tomorrow, you will also die, similar to what you did with all the priests." Scary, right? And it is in this situation that Elijah fled. Fearful for his life, he fled and hid in the cave. In fact, his prayers to God was, "Lord, please take away my life." Do you realize this? Faced with a life-threatening situation, Elijah was ready to give up, even as asked God, "Please take away my life." In the gospel that we have just heard, what's more frightening to be in a sinking boat, or to see a ghost, or yet to see a ghost when you are in a sinking boat, right? Which is more frightening. And so it is in this context that we must realize they already had an experience with Jesus on a stormy sea of Galilee. In Matthew 8, when they were traveling across the lake, there was a big storm, but Jesus was asleep. It's not the first instance, it's the second instance. And yet, in this unpredictable weather, they again to become afraid. That's why when Jesus appeared, he says, in his eye, Peter was in his elements. Peter is a fisherman. He knows the situation, that he has no control over nature, that there could be sudden strong winds on the lake. That is his life. That is his natural environment. But for this particular instance, he took a risk. He took a risk to see the Lord. In fact, we should be grateful for Peter, because he gave up the security of the boats to follow and to come to Jesus. The rest of the disciples, they stayed secured on the boat, were not willing to let go. In all of this, what is it within them that allowed them to continue the call to be witnesses of God? For Elijah, ready to throw in the towel, hiding in the cave, it was an encounter of God in the still, small voice. For the disciples, fearful, it was the assuring words of Jesus Christ saying, "It is I am presence, do not be afraid." And Peter himself, who feared the storms started to drown, the Lord reached out to him and rescued him. Mercy was extended to Peter. Mercy is extended to all of us. What is it within us that will continue us to journey amidst this pandemic and the resurgence of COVID and all the additional quarantine being laid upon us? What is it within us? God's presence. That is the reassuring words of God. That's why Jesus told them, "Oh, you men of little faith." It is not a question of disbelief, but rather, it's when the disciples started to lose their trust in God out of a fearful situation. When they started to lose confidence and faith as they faltered because of a frightful event. It's been 6 months. And we know we're not seeing as yet the light at the end of the tunnel with this COVID-19. In fact, there are resurgences and different strains. But the question is, are you experiencing God's presence right here, right now? Just as he had allowed himself to be experienced by Elijah and the apostles and Peter. This is why we come to Mass. This week, why we come to the Eucharist, to encounter the presence of Jesus Christ. This is what is within us that we could bring out and share with others. As we receive the Holy Communion, let's ask for three graces. The grace of discernment. The grace to say, "Lord, let me come to you." We ask the grace of mercy when we say, "Lord, save us." And finally, let us ask for the grace of worship when we say, "Indeed, Jesus, you are the Son of God. You have never forsaken me. You are with me right here, right now, wherever I am. you are presence. The teenager asked, give me what is within you that made you really give violently. Your friends, your family members are asking you, give me, share with me whom you have within you that I may experience faith at this difficult time.
Please stand. Together let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, through God from through God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us pray for all those who enable the work of the gospel to go on today. Our Holy Father, the Pope, our bishops and clergy, all missionaries throughout the world, and all who cooperate with them.
For those whose works help our society to support us in healthcare, education, security, utilities, industry, and in any other way, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those overwhelmed by the storms of life in unemployment, sickness, or homelessness, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For young people who fear for the future, that we may take their concerns seriously, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this nation and every nation, that there may be progress toward peace through justice, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all here present at the Lord's table, and for all who cannot be here because of age or illness, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the members of our communities who are sick and homebound, especially Sarah Caspino, our family members, those listed in our parish book of intentions, and those who care for them, may they encounter God's holiness and healing in the midst of their trials, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have died, especially our family members, parishioners, and all the souls in purgatory, may enjoy the eternal peace and rest of God's heavenly home, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the intentions of those in the medical field responsible for public health, doctors, nurses, and all hospital personnel, and those responsible for public safety, especially the firefighters, EMS, police and military personnel, and for their families worrying at home, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
for the intentions of the Sarah Bryant Ohana and all of us gathered here, those spoken aloud and those held in the silence of our hearts. For these, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Let us also pray for an end to this coronavirus pandemic. Let's also pray for victims of natural and man-made calamities and disasters, especially the recent disaster that happened in Beirut. We pray for those who have died, the wounded. We continue to pray that countries struggling for peace, for equality and justice. We continue to pray that leaders of nations throughout the world, our church leaders and leaders of our civil society may continue to work together as enlightened by the Holy Spirit, setting aside the differences to assist the most affected by this pandemic. For all this, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let's also pray for our schools, our Catholic schools, all throughout the diocese, that as we face the uncertainties of every day, our Lord may continue to guide our heads of schools, principals, directors, our teachers, and all our staff. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God, our Heavenly Father, we thank you for watching over us. As we try to remain faithful to your word, be pleased to hear the prayers of our hearts as we pray through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our preparation song can be found projected on the screen. That's Be Not Afraid. Once again, Be Not Afraid, projected on the screen.
Thank you.
pray, beloved ones in Christ Jesus, that my sacrifice and yours may become acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Be pleased, O Lord, to accept the offerings of your church, for in your mercy you have given them to be offered, and by your power you transformed them into the mystery of our salvation through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body, we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raise up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so, with all the angels, we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. Glorified, O God, who loved the human race, and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst, when we are gathered by his love, and when as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit, to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and gave you thanks, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and granted by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. And so, having called us to your table, Lord, confirm us in unity, so that together with Francis our Pope and Larry our Bishop, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, and your entire people, as we walk your ways with faith and hope, we may strive to bring joy and trust into the world. Remember our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever, there in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the apostles and martyrs, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Trusting in God's loving mercy, at Jesus' command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to the apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord Jesus be with you always.
Let us offer one another the sign of peace.
Behold Jesus, the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring eternal life to us who receive Him. Amen.
Communion song can be found projected on the screen. That's Behold the Lamb. Once again, Behold the Lamb projected on the screen. Thank you.
Please stand and let us pray. May the communion in your sacrament that we have consumed save us, O Lord, and confirm us in the light of your truth through Christ our Lord.
Volunteers will be needed to help disinfect and sanitize the highly touched surfaces inside and in front of our church after the Mass. We appreciate your help. Thank you all for coming together to worship as God's family. We look forward to celebrating with you next Saturday and Sunday and wish everyone a grace-filled, faith-filled, safe and healthy week ahead. As God's stewards, let us all be continually involved in our parish community. Please join us in our sending forth hymn, Let There Be Peace on Earth, which will be projected on the screen. Again, that's Let There Be Peace on Earth. Mahalo, and have a blessed evening.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord through one another.
Thanks be to God.
I've